It's now quiet, it's not as noisy as it was. Oh, there's no way through here. Okay, I'm just go. Thank you. Okay. Yeah, so there's this car park that we got through here. That way. So there's this car park. Wow, that's nice. Actually closed on Sundays for this roller skating and rollerblading. That's what all these guys inside here do. Blading. Big line is here. And then we have the guys, the photo guys are here again. Thank you. vending and the skate team. People are rollerblading inside here, all around. Okay, one is riding a bike. They're like going really fast. So this is the Maasai market. So it's finished now. So most of the guys are clearing up their stuff and going. So you can see this is it. They're clearing up. Clearing up after another hard day doing the Maasai market. So you can see that's it there, inside there. Inside there, you can see some of the things are still displayed here. Here, it's now quite dark. So the street guys have now started. And these guys are closing up and cooperating. And in the night, we've started. That's the Maasai market. Closed now. Pronto restaurant. So now this part of town is a bit more quiet. We've come away from all the action of downtown. So you can really see downtown, there's action. Things are going on. Life is just beginning. The guys who sell on the street were putting now their merchandise and then selling. Because of course the council is not there. So this part of town is where we have the youths taking these Instagram photos and whatever. So you can see, even late into the night, this is what happens. They've come all dressed in this town, city, CBD, so they take photos, videos, probably do Instagram reels, and then they upload them. So it's a trend. So digital technology, social media is big in the world. It's really big, you can see. It's like this Sunday is like reserved for the young generation to come and do all their digital media, social media, and all that. You can see they stand in the middle of the streets, skateboarding, enjoying. As if this town has been opened for them, and they're literally going wild, skating around the CBD, just doing wild things. I think feeling free, they're feeling free. So now we coming to the outer parts of the town, so it's quieter, and this is where the unlike the other parts we saw. So I'm sure you saw Nairobi, CBD at night. So moving up now. So I'm going to get some dinner now at cafe Java's. I don't want to cook now. I can't. Get some dinner, go home, do a bit of work, do a bit of study, sleep, wake up tomorrow, nice and early, ready for another hard day. So this was a lot of action when we came, but now it's a bit more quiet. A few more still remaining. They really love their reels and all that. So they're like really enjoying these youth. They're really enjoying it. Yeah. So that's where we came from. I think we've been walking like for an hour or so. I don't know how long. We'll see. But we've walked for quite long. We came past here, J Quad Towers. Yeah. So, yeah, this is Nairobi CBD at night. Let me see what is the time now. So we came just before it was dark. It's 20 past 7, no? 20 past 7. So I think we came just before 6, and this is actually a good exercise for social media. Just walk around, taking raw videos, raw footage, and show people out there. So the Instagrammers are still there, there's still a few. Can see them. Most have gone. I think most of them wanted to take advantage of the sunset because there was still some light. It was not completely dark. the sun was setting, so they could take advantage of that way. It's just about get dark, but there's just some light, and then the lights in the city are being turned on, most of the shops, so it gives a very good effect. I saw some doing some like 10 second 15 second reel videos. Yeah, so this is Nairobi for you. Let's see. We're walking in the streets at night. Yeah, even I think I've even done 10,000 steps. Yeah, 10,000 steps. Goal achieved. My smartwatch. So, yeah, now we're gonna look for a bit of dinner. We go for dinner. We'll keep showing you the city. That's where we came from. That way there. See all these matatus. The noisy, noisy matatus. Yeah. So we're here. Right. So we're going into Cafe Java's now. We're going to Cafe Java's for our dinner. So there's a lot of businesses in Nairobi. The CBD is very well maintained. I think you guys saw from the videos, even at night. Very well maintained. Paving is done nicely. The roads are done nicely. The buildings are still in very good shape. Here the youth of tomorrow still taking final videos. Final videos. Cafe Deli. I don't know what Cafe Deli is. I need something good. So you can see wide tower, good buildings, still maintained, and yeah, the businesses are still there operating in the city. So yeah, I can say Nairobi is a good city, and also part of the businesses have decentralized into other parts, but either way they've really maintained all the parts. Businesses seem to be doing well. Of course, they're still tough. Economy is tough because of US dollar shortage in every country now. General outlook of the economy is also a bit tough. So these are like some tourist bus. So here they usually sell flowers during the day. But now they're all gone. This is the local market. Fish, whatnot. And here's the remnants of the guys who sell the flowers. This is what is remaining. So we saw this at dusk. So there is some good urban heat there. I think they do urban beggars. Okay, so we're going there. CJ's Cafe Java's. Going there. You wanna grab some dinner? And then we'll go home. So I love their masala tea, and I love their range of soups. So we'll definitely have some masala tea, soup, and then if we're still hungry, we can grab a meal, or we can just take a little something small. Hello.